than Dwayne Simpkins. Simpkins, the number one three-point shooter in the conference.
And Maryland is a team, Bob, that doesn't shoot the ball real well all the time. And so when Dwayne Simpkins is shooting it well, generally Maryland plays well.
The Tar Heels starting Vince Carter, Antoine Jameson, Serge Zwicker up front. The backcourt of McGinnis and Calabria. Dante bouncing back with a big offensive game at State Saturday.
Bob, one thing about Calabria, he just doesn't make very many mistakes. Only 42 turnovers on the year. He also had 9 rebounds against North Carolina State. He's a guy who gives the Tar Heels everything they need and very rarely causes them any trouble.
The Tar Heels ranked number 12 in the country. The ACC leaders at 7-2, trying to protect that first place standing against Maryland. The tip-off, straight ahead. Still, the Terrapins at 11-7 overall. Getting set to go against the Tar Heels. The head coach of the Terps, Gary Williams, 4-11 lifetime against the Tar Heels. But one here in 90, that was just his third ACC game. And for Dean Smith of the Tar Heels, his first career game against Maryland came 34 years ago tonight, losing to Bud Milliken's Terps at Cole Fieldhouse, 79-62, but not too many losses against the Terps since then. Antoine Jameson of the Tar Heels, ready to go to work against Maryland. The first one decided in overtime. In fact, the last two games of the Carolina-Maryland series have gone overtime. You'll recall that nail-biter in the ACC tournament last year.
Bob, even though North Carolina turned the ball over 23 times in the first game against Maryland, they got plenty of good shot opportunities. Shot 57%, and I think that was a big key to the victory.
Dick Paparo, Bob Donato, and Sam Croft are officials tonight. Jameson and Nikhizi to decide the center jump, and Maryland has it.
North Carolina starts in a man-to-man.
Nikhizi against Zwicker. And the rebound comes to Vince Carter, ahead to Dante.
Man-to-man defense for the Terrapins.
Carter had it stripped by Johnny Rhodes. They got it back and misfired, hit the rebound.
Of course, Johnny Rhodes, one of the all-time greats in the ACC in terms of steals. Carter had best be careful protecting the ball.
Hip on the baseline. Easy got a hand on it, but that was all.
Bob, this is a North Carolina team that's very difficult to attack when they're playing in their set defense, and the Maryland Terrapins would certainly like to create some turnovers against Dean Smith's ball club and get down the court before Maryland can set, before North Carolina can set the defense.
Jameson. But quickly gets the offensive follow, slammed back by Booth, and Simpkins is running.
Nice job by North Carolina to get back. Maryland was pushing it, looking for that easy opportunity, but the Tar Heels back effectively.
X-ray hip back to life over the weekend against Georgia Tech with 15 points. Next plays to Simpkins as the shot clock hits 10. Long three, and Johnny Rhodes opens the scoring.
Maryland with some pressure.
And they'll leave that pressure up just about all night long. McGinnis tries to tie it. You know, 33rd three.
If you don't get turnovers out of the pressure, Bob, there are going to be some open opportunities for North Carolina.
Rhodes dumps to Akizi. And the Nigerian freshman putting it in. Looking back through the years for this Maryland senior class, they have not won here in Chapel Hill as Akizi picks up his first. But the one number, Dan, that jumped out at me, the fact that they have given up a ton of points. Last year, North Carolina scored 100 against Maryland with Joe Smith, and they missed 20 free throws. Zwicker. Booth kicks it ahead to Simpkins.
Slow start to the basketball game, even though Maryland is trying to push the ball.
Calabria missing the three. There's Booth rebounding. Fifth in the conference at 8.3. Calabria with a steal on a tough pass from Hip. He was about stride for stride with Rhodes.
Now, Calabria was back in excellent position, Bob. North Carolina does a nice job getting back on defense.
This foul goes against Johnny Rhodes. It's his first.
And Maryland has to be careful that as they get in their up-tempo game and run up and down, that they not be a little lazy on the defensive end. They've got to get back on defense and get set quickly, because North Carolina, as Okalaja comes in the game, particularly with McGinnis and Calabria, will get the quick penetration.
Now North Carolina's got to get somebody off the floor. Here's going to be Vince Carter. I don't think Gary would go along with that. You know, home court advantage is one thing, but 6-on-5 is another story.
Sometimes it seems like it's 6-on-5.
Yes, it does. Okalaja.
Big lineup now for North Carolina. Be interesting to see if they can create any problems with an inside matchup, Okalaja against Johnny Rhodes.
Here's Dante, feeding it low. Jamison draws the contact.
And that's Akizi, and that's two very early. We talked about the ability of North Carolina to penetrate, this time Calabria with the pass that penetrates the defense. And what a great catch inside by Jamison. Jamison's one of his great strengths is that he moves very well without the ball. He found the open area that time. And a guy like Calabria can find him.
Antoine shooting just 55.8. Keezy with the two fouls out of the ballgame now for the Terrapins. Mario Lucas is in. Jamison hits the second shot.
Be interesting to see if North Carolina can now get inside a little bit more. They go to the zone defense to the Tar Heels.
And Boot inside. Oh, two-hand reverse doesn't go.
That's awfully tough to get that shot up over Zwicker. Maryland was looking tonight for some offensive rebounding as well, but thus far North Carolina has done a nice job preventing.
Zwicker with the hook.
If North Carolina can make it a half-court game, Zwicker can be a very big factor offensively.
Search took four stitches above the left eye with that contact with Antoine Jamison at NC State Saturday night. Wearing a headband to help on the perforated eardrum problem. Here's Booth backing one in.
It's good that his perspiration only comes from the top of his ears. Haven't quite figured out how a headband keeps the perspiration out of your ears, but they say it does, so I'm buying it.
7-6 Maryland. McGinnis.
Maryland has not had, or excuse me, North Carolina has not had any difficulty operating against the Maryland defense, Bob.
Three from Mario Lucas.
Well, that's what he does. He comes off the bench and shoots threes. Had four in the first game against the Tar Heels. But now he's going to be pushing Zwicker inside.
McGinnis to Jamison. Okalaja, the offensive rebound. Here's Calabria dumping it to Zwicker. North Carolina having its way against the Maryland defense. Floor is Terrell Stokes gets set to come in for Maryland. We'll be back after this message from Budweiser. 3-point advantage. Dan Bonner, the Terrapins have been out rebounded in 7 straight ACC games, and it's developing tonight like that number is going to go to 8.
North Carolina with an early 8-4 edge, Bob, but more importantly, Maryland has 0 offensive rebounds at this point.
And Lucas off the leg of a Tar Heel and out of bounds. Maryland possession with 21 on the shot clock.
Bob, and as Gary Williams looks at this game early, he knows that his Terrapins have yet to force a North Carolina turnover. The Tar Heels are doing the job on the boards. And after a slow shooting start, North Carolina has gotten some very, very good looks at the basket.
Johnny Rhodes inside to Lucas, back out to Rhodes, and into the third row. The gentleman in the yellow sweater was open.
But interestingly enough, he was talking to one of the cheerleaders and he didn't see the pass.
And I don't blame him. 10:43 left in the half. 10-7 Carolina.
North Carolina's zone defense has seemed to cause the Terrapins to become a little bit passive on the offensive end.
Swerves it up top. Carter feeds inside to Ogallala. And the reach-in foul on Terrell Stokes.
Not a lot of pressure on the perimeter, Bob. Not a lot of pressure on the basketball by the Maryland defense. Ogallala gets himself in position. Lucas is actually a step away. Stokes reaches in and gets the foul, but the whole key to that is Lucas has very little pressure inside, but there was no pressure on the ball. That was a very easy pass to make.
Antoine Jameson returns for the Tar Heels, and Ogallala has it knocked out of his hands by Rhodes.
I'm telling you, you've got to be careful with the basketball when Johnny Rhodes is anywhere in the neighborhood.
Johnny, a guard by trade, but playing a lot at the small forward position. With his quick hands, he can make life miserable for a lot of small forwards around the ACC and has this season.
And he's such a good rebounder, too, Bob, that he's a guy who can play that inside position when he has to.
And Johnny Rhodes with the steal and a foul on Ogallala. Credit Johnny with steal number 70 this season and the 304th of his career.
Ogallala is going to have a difficult time putting it on the deck, trying to dribble through two guards, that time Rhodes and Stokes. That's the first North Carolina foul. That's one thing the Tar Heels haven't done very much, Bob. They foul much less than their opposition.
Lucas shut off on a travel. Great D by Zwicker that time.
Thus far, Gary Williams and his team have not been able to solve that North Carolina zone.
Dan, you've made the comment when we've watched the Tar Heels defend during this season about opponents should make the Tar Heels work defensively. Does that hold true for Maryland also?
Well, Maryland's got to play the style that they're most comfortable with, Bob, and that's running up and down, but that doesn't mean in a half-court situation you shoot the ball quickly. I think they should be trying to beat the zone down the court. Calabria scores. But I think in a half-court set, yes, they need to move the ball. They need to move the Tar Heels around. Quick shots are not going to beat the zone. See, it's become a half-court game, Bob, particularly for North Carolina on the defensive end, so Zwicker's able to get set and be a real factor.
The Tar Heels had been starting slowly in ACC, but they're up 12-7, 7 minutes and 20 seconds into the proceedings.
And Zwicker stands there in the middle of that play. He's a tough guy to get around.
Shows the clenched fist to the bench, indicating that he's in need of a blow is Johnny Rhodes. It's his second three. Ogallala getting it over to Jameson as the Tar Heels work it up.
And again, North Carolina has had no problems with the Maryland pressure.
Rhodes nearly had that one measured too. Jameson down the lane. Gets it back and puts it in. He is so quick off his feet.
Bob, he really gets back up, hits the ground, and gets back up after the ball as quickly as anybody I've seen in a long time.
Keith Booth missing the three. Lucas runs down the rebound.
It's an offensive rebound for Maryland, Bob, but a very quick shot. If they're going to shoot the ball quickly, it better go in the basket or they're in for a long night.
Rhodes an air ball. McGinnis leads it 2-on-1. And Maryland gets back a foul on Prophet. For both ball clubs. Dwayne Simpkins coming in for Maryland and Vince Carter for the Tar Heels when we come back after this message from Continental, the official airline of the ACC.
At Continental, we've been listening to you. And you can see the changes. Something new here. A renewed sense of pride there. And lately, we've become among the best in the business at handling your baggage and getting you to your destination on time. So fly us again and see the changes for yourself.
Sleep, but sleep won't come.
will tell on you.
When we put together numbers like these for an annual percentage rate, it's no wonder you think of Central Fidelity when you think of home equity loans. You can think just 24 hours for approval, too. And you can apply at over 240 branches statewide. So if you're looking for a home equity loan, now more than ever, the numbers tell the story. Central Fidelity is where to borrow.
North Carolina leading Maryland 14-10. We have 11:40 remaining in our first half. The Terrapins rebounding from an 0-3 ACC start to even the conference record at 4-4. But tonight, they're struggling, both offensively and defensively.
Bob, and I think the key is their struggles on the defensive end. The thing that has keyed, or one of the things that has keyed Maryland's recent success is on the defensive end of the court. They've been playing very well, forcing turnovers, forcing an up-tempo game, and that's simply not what we've had here in the first 8-plus minutes of this basketball game. It's been a half-court kind of game. North Carolina has been able to use their advantages inside.
Shamon Williams has checked in for the Tar Heels. Handles it against Johnny Rhodes. And off the fingertips of Williams. The second Carolina turnover.
And again, Okalaja takes and tries to rubbing his temples there a little bit, and you can understand. But that's Johnny Rhodes putting pressure on Okalaja, forcing him to throw the difficult pass.
Down the lane, and he puts it in. Moran, the freshman from Dover, Delaware, his first two. Now, despite the difficulties, Maryland's only down a basket.
Maryland now starting to get their hands on some of the North Carolina passes, Bob. Prophet has done a nice job picking up the defensive intensity since he's come in the ballgame.
Shot clock at 10. Jamison. And Carter with a magnificent slam follow.
Gary Williams suggesting to Prophet that possibly he ought to block Carter out.
And I would think that maybe the next time down the floor that would be re-emphasized by Mr. Williams. 16-12 Tar Heels. Prophet misfires and Jamison clears to McGinnis.
Success on offense against North Carolina. I think you have to make the extra pass.
Okalaja missing the three, but there's Carter again.
And Gary Williams wants a 20-second timeout. And I think if I'm Moran Prophet, I don't want to go over there. Doesn't look like anybody's in a good situation over there.
18-12, Carolina. This is the first Carter slam.
Well, he's lost in there. Nobody sees him. There's no red shirt anywhere close to him. He was asking for the ball and didn't get it. This time he's at least surrounded by Terrapins, but he does a nice job getting it up on the court. You can see why people are excited about his potential.
Texas Bank, a corporate partner of the 96 Olympics, presents this Olympics salute to excellence question. Women began playing competitive basketball in 1893. What year did women's basketball become an Olympic sport? We'll have the answer a little bit later. 18-12, North Carolina at 10:04 in the first half.
We talked about the rebounding. North Carolina, a 14-6 edge overall and 5-1 on the offensive boards.
So after getting an earful from Gary Williams, Rhodes misses the three. Lucas, an offensive rebound, but it's rejected by Jamison.
Just because you get an offensive rebound, Bob, you don't have to shoot it right back up there. Booth making a good decision to get it out and get the offense started.
Johnny Rhodes on the baseline, in traffic and a travel. Fourth Maryland turnover. Calabria coming back for the Tar Heels and McGinnis going out.
Nothing seems smooth for the Terrapins on the offensive end at the moment, Bob.
9:30 left in the first half.
Man-to-man for Maryland. Keith Booth now matched up against Zwicker. Maryland!
is open for three. Inside and outside. Vince Carter with seven.
Maryland had cut it to two, and then Carter took over. Carter scored seven in a row.
Tar Heels up the lead to nine. Simpkins. Shot clock now under 10 as Simpkins hits a three.
That's a big basket. The North Carolina defense, you can just see they've got everything for Maryland pushed to the perimeter. Looks like the Terrapins are going to have to knock a couple of those threes down.
21-15 Tar Heels. Calabria, rhythm bounce, shot it short. Rhodes missing, and out of bounds to the Tar Heels. Changes for Maryland. Rodney Elliott, Nikhizi, and Hip all come back to the lineup. Booth, Lucas, and Prophet getting a rest.
And Nikhizi comes back in the ballgame with those two personal fouls.
Dante Calabria hit four threes and scored 21 in game one at College Park. Jamison to Carter. And Vince, rebounded by Simpkins. Pushes it in, count it, and a foul on Calabria.
It's really the first transition basket for the Terrapins, and Johnny Rhodes making a smart play. You'd expect Simpkins and Rhodes to make smart plays like this, but Rhodes senses the defense, stops, take the short jump shot. Maryland hasn't gotten a shot like that against the set North Carolina defense, so it's a great job to take that opportunity in transition.
Johnny is 61% foul shooter this season. Dunbar High School in Washington. Rebound follow for Elliott. So Maryland right back in it. After the explosion from Vince Carter, Carolina's lead back to two. McGinnis. And it's stripped by Rhodes, but gets it back. Jamal Williams, and that's a travel. A timeout on the floor with 7:14 remaining in the first half. Vince Carter's slam to put Carolina up nine. Now this from Budweiser.
Insurance agent said it reminded him of his first house. It needed a little work.
Patty and her husband got their friends together.
We got the place looking great.
Yeah, I was able to help a little. I mean, since they now have a homeowner's policy with Nationwide, I could offer them a home car discount.
It was a really nice little housewarming gift. I'm glad Joe saved us money because we still have a few little things that need to be fixed up. Like
Nationwide is on your side.
How can this be car of the year? You can't get up and walk around in a car. Cars don't have seats on rollers. Or so many seats, period. Or so much space for so many things. And they certainly don't offer sliding doors on both sides. Well then, it would appear that for the first time ever, the Motor Trend Car of the Year is more than a car. It's a caravan from the new Dodge.
Coming up this weekend, we have three big games for you. First, on Saturday, we'll be in Tallahassee, Florida, as the Maryland Terrapins take on Kirk Luckman and the Florida State Seminoles. Then at 4 o'clock, Clemson is at Virginia, where Jamal Robinson and the Cavaliers look for revenge from an earlier loss to the Tigers. Then on Sunday, The Duke Blue Devils traveled to Winston-Salem to meet the Deacs, who won Game 1 in Durham by 3. That's this weekend on the Raycom at Jefferson Pilot Sports Network. 21-19, North Carolina leading Maryland by 2.
Bob, it's sort of been a funny game so far. Each team playing without very much intensity, it seems. Maryland matching that Vince Carter run now to bring it back within 2.
And Johnny Rhodes looking to tie, but there's the big man, Akizi, putting in the follow shot.
Rhodes' ability to get inside, play with his back to the basket, forced the defense to collapse on him. Zwicker had to cover up Rhodes and was not able to block out Akizi.
Jamon Williams. Jameson runs in to Akizi, and Johnny Rhodes knocks that one away. Gets it back. Simpkins for 3. 5 rebounds for Jameson. He scored 3 points. Williams pounds it into Jameson. Banks it and hits it.
I don't know whether he meant to bank it or not. In an interesting, Jamon Williams passed up a wide open 3 just after he missed a 3. Confidence is a funny thing.
Rhodes in the middle of the lane to Elliott.
How did he catch that? And then how did he get it around Zwicker?
Like to see him draw that one up.
And now they may have an inbounds violation. I think Jameson stepped inbounds before he passed the ball inbounds. Dean Smith not particularly happy with that play.
5:56 remaining. That's the 5th Tar Heel turnover as Sarunas Yesakavicius comes in now for Maryland. And Rhodes gets a breather. He'll be out for a brief time, to be sure. Hip in the corner. Penetrates. Akizi again inside, and it's knocked out of bounds by Okalaja. A big man making his presence felt.
Well, again, Terrapins forcing the action. That time, Zwicker had to go and stop the penetration of Hip.
Akizi getting it out to Simpson.
He looks like he's more comfortable closer to the basketball.
Yes. No doubt.
He was in front of that guy with the yellow sweater again. That guy's already
who's still
one.
Open, by the way.
Yeah, hopefully he's paying more attention now, though.
Hip for 3. Last touched.
That's
Rodney Elliott. Yep.
Bob, the last time down the court, I thought Maryland was playing a triangle and 2 defense, and that looks like what they're lining up in right now, with Hip covering Calabria, Simpkins covering McGinnis, and everybody else playing zone or matching up.
Zwicker from the baseline. That big jumper Saturday night at State. Got the lead to 2 late in the game with about 30 seconds to go. Nice touch on the baseline there.
Man-to-man defense for the Tar Heels.
25-23, North Carolina. Elliott put it on the floor, and that was a big mistake. But Okalaja, no, it's going to be on Elliott. After the ball was taken away, Rodney fouled.
Got to figure, Bob, as a big guy. Now watch this. There's 2 guys around, and the mistake he makes is dribbling the ball, because that gives Okalaja a chance to get in there and get him in the shoulder, in the chest, knocking the guy down. Will usually get called for a foul. Elliott's made 2 mistakes. Dribbled the ball on the inside in a crowd, and then fouled.
Jameson blocked. Gets it back and softly puts it in.
Bob, he's almost more dangerous on the second shot than the first, because everybody's down, and while they're just gathering themselves to go back up again, he's got the ball.
Amazing. 27-23 inside. X-ray Hip. Nice feed. And Elliott. And Zwicker takes it away.
Jameson got that one.
Simpkins trying to get something rolling in transition. And does. Simpkins' second bucket. Pulls Maryland's Terrapins within 2.
Triangle and 2 defense. That's an aggressive point to the triangle. Yes, the Cavish is out there being very physical.
And a travel on Jeff McGinnis. And with 3:44 left in the half, we've got a timeout on the floor here at the Smith Center in Chapel Hill. 27-25 Tar Heels.
With each new season, they rouse themselves from their dens. The ACC Superfan. Starved for ACC basketball and food, they're drawn to Food Lion. There they quench their thirst, satisfy their hunger, and get everything else they need. And when they use their MVP card, they can win tickets to the ACC and the National College Basketball Championship. If you see an ACC superfan, beware. They're usually not alone. Food Lion. Extra low prices and more for the ACC superfan.
Advance Auto Parts presents part number 23, the foot. Advance Auto Parts salespeople come equipped with 2 feet capable of propelling them out the door to your car.
It seems like I'm feeling every bump in the road.
Step by step, your car is inspected. With your problem understood, it's just a short walk back to the parts department. At Advance Auto Parts, no one sits around on part number 41. Advance Auto Parts, the best part is our people.
The new 4000 laser printer.
Kicking DPIs.
Mega res output.
Killer.
Slamming cool. Slamming.
A whole generation slipping right past us, Alan.
I'll say. I can save that fella Mega on a screaming 1200 DPI printer. Excuse me, sir. I couldn't help.
Hey, son, can you do me like you did that last dude?
Digital computers, laser printers, connected systems, advanced business systems. We live and breathe this stuff.
Our nation's bank questioned earlier, what year did women's basketball become an Olympic sport? And the correct answer, 1976 at Montreal.
And interestingly enough, Bob, the U.S. women's national team completing their tour of the country here, as fine a group of women's basketball players as ever collected. And they're striving for that Olympic gold in 1996.
Final. My goodness. 77-28.
It was like a Nebraska football score. Here's zone defense for North Carolina. And yes, Akavicius is the guy who's supposed to be able to shoot it, has struggled this year, but he knocked it in that time.
And Maryland takes the lead by one.
This defense has seemed to give North Carolina some problems.
You know, I can't remember, Dan, a year in the ACC at Zwickerhooks that we have seen more teams be more successful with jump defenses.
Bob, I think it's a matter of the coaches getting used to playing with the 35-second shot clock, not only offensively but defensively.
Keith Booth up and off.
Now, you don't want to force that offensive rebound back up there unless you're going to be able to dunk it, and that's a double dribble. You know, there are teams, I haven't seen it done much in the ACC, but there's a lot of teams around the country, Bob, that are actually playing, that they're switching their defense as the shot clock runs down. They start in a zone, and then with 10 seconds left on the shot clock, they switch into a man-to-man. So coaches are playing a little bit with that shot clock, trying to make it more difficult for the opposing offenses.
Yes, Akavicius on the baseline. Akizi in the paint. And that is going to be, let's see.
It's going to
count the basket. And a foul on North Carolina. Goaltending against the Tar Heels as Akizi took it inside.
The key there is Zwicker has to go out and help the penetration. Zwicker's out of the play. Carter makes a bad mistake right there to slap that ball. But Zwicker, when he's able to stay under the basket, really clogs things up in there. That time he stepped to the corner, and that created the opening for Akizi.
Only in the United States since 1993, Akizi started playing basketball at the urging of his father, who is an oil company executive who travels in the U.S. And Akizi now in his first year of college basketball. 30-29, Maryland. Feeding it back to Stokes, to Booth. Maryland better ball movement of late as Lucas drains the three.
Bob, that extra pass, a little bit of patience, and moving the ball from side to side has been very successful.
33-31 Maryland.
Man-to-man defense for the Tar Heels.
Jamison really pushing against Booth on the inside.
Keith spins in. Got Jamison out of the way and banked it home.
Again, Zwicker had gone out of the middle of the lane, Bob, and when Zwicker leaves the middle of the lane, Maryland has been able to operate on the inside.
35-31 Terps. Calabria missing the three. Jesse Cavicius ahead to Terrell Stokes. Tip no good. Hit the offensive rebound, and that rolls in.
That was a powerful move inside by X-ray Hip.
You know, Dean Smith's Tar Heels, Bob, have not done a good job moving the ball from side to side. Some quick shots on the offensive end.
Biggest Maryland lead. Coming down to the final seconds of the first half. And a foul on Lucas. Pushing against Antoine Jamison, and that will put the Tar Heels into the bonus.
Bob, as we look at the jostling for position inside, I've been sitting here trying to see whether Maryland was still in that triangle and two defense as you get the foul against Lucas, and it's difficult for me to tell because Zwicker and Jamison are establishing themselves on the blocks. They're never moving from side to side, so the Maryland guys never have to move. A couple of quick shots have the Tar Heels in a hole.
Jamison now with 8, 31 in the first game at Maryland.
Bob, we talked about how this guy may be more dangerous the second time around than the first. He's got 4 offensive rebounds today, 3 rebounding his own misses.
My goodness. Another offensive opportunity here for Siobhan Williams.
We've talked about how aggressive he's been. He gets the hand on the way by. That aggressiveness cost Maryland right there. You don't want to foul the three-point jump shooter. 20-second timeout called by North Carolina.
Siobhan Williams will get a free throw when we come back in a moment. Maryland 37-35 with 22.7. Congratulations go to David Thompson, the Shelby, North Carolina native. Got the great news that he was inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame in Springfield. And joining that class of inductees this May, the numbers that Thompson posted at NC State, just incredible. And if you had the chance to see him play, you know how deserving he is. And that man could not have been happier to hear the news. Phil Ford, the Tar Heel assistant coach, who was a freshman at Carolina when Thompson was a senior, was so excited for David. And we extend our congratulations to David and his family on a most worthy honor of the Basketball Hall of Fame.
Bob, I got to see David Thompson up closer than I was interested in sometimes. And without any question, he's the best player I ever saw.
Amazing. Stokes guarded by McGinnis. That clock's draining. Terrell with a head up. Here comes the trap. Stokes baseballs it across to Jesse Cavicius. That's up and off. McGinnis has got it. 2 seconds. McGinnis beats the horn, and it is no good. And the first half comes to an end. The Tar Heels are trailing again at halftime, but tonight it's only by 2. Maryland 37 and North Carolina 35.
ACC Basketball is brought to you by Nationwide Insurance.
We'll have the start of the second half for you when we return to Carolina right after this.
In the Chrysler brand, that's one word.
Last Saturday, my wife Lisa and I went shopping. You know, we're not paying any attention. That's when it hit me. What would happen to our family if Lisa weren't around anymore?
Well, recently I've been trying to get Dave and Lisa to review their life insurance.
We then called Kim. She's our nationwide insurance agent.
Lisa now has the life insurance she needs.
Sometimes I think about what almost happened. But thanks to Kim, I don't worry about what might happen.
Nationwide is on your side.
Every week, Pizza Hut talks to 50,000 people all across America.
Hello?
Hello, this is Pizza Hut.
I didn't know I had pizza.
Because we want to know what you think.
The delivery guy was right on time. I gave the green peppers to my sister, and it was just the right amount of cheese. I love pizza for breakfast. In fact, Dad likes pizza better than Mom's cooking.
After all, it's not our Pizza Hut. It's your Pizza Hut.
Call back anytime you want some advice.
You'll love the stuff we're made of.
Here in the South, we have a tradition of service you won't find anywhere else. And at Bell South, we're helping businesses serve their customers more effectively every day. With more advanced technology than ever before. Business is growing faster here than in any other part of the country. It's easy to see why. Bell South, it's all here.
Jefferson Pilot Sports exclusive coverage of ACC basketball is brought to you by Discus Athletic, by DirecTV, by Nationwide Insurance, by Chrysler, by Advance Auto Parts, and by Budweiser.
Tar Heel basketball trailing by two as we begin the second half of play from the Smith Center. Bob Rathman, Dan Bonner with you from Chapel Hill. Dante Calabria just in front of us plays it into Jeff McGinnis, and we're underway with the second half.
Maryland applying the pressure at half court.
Trying to spring a trap.
2-1.
McGinnis underneath Jamison, and it batted away. Simpkins picks it up, and here's X-Ray hit running the court. And a foul on Carter.
Way if you're Maryland, you'd like to come out and start the second half. That's the Terrapin game, creating that turnover, and then Hip doing a great job running down the court, finally starting to round into playing shape, and he got down the court quickly, and Dwayne Simpkins, one of the best assist guys in Maryland history, hits him in full stride. That was a perfect pass.
X had 15 against Georgia Tech Saturday. He had scored only 17 points in his previous four games. He's looking at point number five tonight. He's got it. The Terrapin lead goes to five.
Of course, one of the problems that Hip has been having as we get a look at Dean Smith is that he's been on the bench a lot. It's tough to score from the bench, but Gary Williams has said X-Ray's got to earn that playing time.
Calabria with a soft touch. Only four for Dante. We talked about that triangle of two that Maryland was playing.
Maryland has changed the defense now, Bob. They've gone to that trapping pressure, that ball off Zwicker. He had 8 points in this first half. Serge Zwicker. Jamison had eight, Carter had seven, so the starting front line for North Carolina scoring very effectively, but not many points from the backcourt. Tar Heels in the zone.
Johnny Rhodes for three. Air ball.
Needed to back up a couple of feet.
Carter. This is his three-point attempt.
Great block out by Keith Booth.
Simpkins trap.
Boy, we've had so many traveling violations in this game, Bob. In the first half, five turnovers for Maryland and eight for North Carolina. And I'll bet you at least six or seven of those were walking violations. Here's the half-court pressure.
Back in the middle to McGinnis. Carter baseline across to Zwicker. And we've got a foul on Keith Booth of Maryland, says Dick Paparo.
And he says that Keith Booth was pulling on the shoulder of Antoine Jameson. It's the first foul on Booth. That's basically hand-to-hand combat in there. You've got to get the body on Jameson, literally, and keep him from getting off the court. And Booth is trying to be very physical with him, but got caught that time.
And Carter denied the baseline because Rhodes had him wrapped up. Second foul on Johnny. Maryland 40, North Carolina 37. What is it?
Still a triangle in two, Bob.
Swicker inside that time.
They just threw that right over the head of Akeezy. He didn't have his hands up, Bob. Swicker did, so that's pretty high up.
Rhodes has it deflected out by Calabria. 17 on the shot clock.
North Carolina does a good job in that zone defense, keeping their hands moving, staying active, playing in the passing lanes, and they're big inside. Zwicker in the middle of the lane is really a factor.
X for three. His first three-pointer of the night, just his seventh of the season. 43-39 Maryland. Easy picks up two fouls early, none since. McGinnis drives, lost it, got it back, rolled it out. Carter had it for an instant. Now Simpkins finds hip at the other end.
That was just a tremendous play by Dwayne Simpkins. He was getting ready to put the ball down for a dribble, but saw hip out in front.
Jameson across the surge, off the window. Good ball movement for the Tar Heels inside.
Hip has all the Maryland points in the second half.
10 for the game. Terps by four. Here's Booth. Nothing doing against Swicker, and a reach-in foul on Carter. Well, that's one Vince would love to have back. Swicker had him pinned.
Here's the end of the previous play with Hip getting another excellent pass from Dwayne Simpkins. On the fast break, Maryland getting some transition opportunities early in the second half.
Vince Carter out of the ballgame for the Tar Heels. Okolaja back in.
Well, you're right. There was no place for Booth to go inside, and Carter really bailed him out by reaching in and committing that foul.
Rhodes around Jameson. Couldn't get it to drop as the big fella came over.
Right. The problem is you get around Jameson, and then Zwicker's there.
Okolaja. Back out to McGinnis.
Outstanding ball movement.
Second three tonight for Jeff. He's got 8 points, and the Maryland lead down to one. And this crowd becoming a factor. And Okolaja going forward and out of bounds. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Maryland ball when we come back. 15:51 remaining in the second half. We'll be back after this message from Budweiser.
Why? Why?
Emergency Roadside Assistance Program. If any AutoCraft Silver Plus battery or premium lifetime warranty alternator or starter should fail within 2 years of purchase, call us. We'll send and pay for a jump or a tow anytime, anywhere in the U.S. and Canada. Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
It may seem like a funny analogy, but building the Chrysler Cirrus was a lot like making a movie. We produced it, released it to a critical audience, and waited for the reviews. Car and Driver called Cirrus the new benchmark for compact sedans. Automobile Magazine raved about its brilliant styling and excellent handling. Motor Trend said it's the most significant vehicle in the market. Cirrus has received great reviews and a lot of awards, but that's no surprise considering its performance.
And Dan Bonner with ACC basketball tonight from the Smith Center in Chapel Hill on the Raycom and Jefferson Pilot Sports Network. And Dan, in four of North Carolina's last five games, they've trailed by 17 points or more. There you see what they've done the last three games in the first halves of those games. Better numbers tonight.
Bob, obviously the key is that shooting percentage. You're down around 33% as opposed to being at 50%. That's a big difference in the ballgame. One of the things that they're not doing tonight, though, is getting to the free throw line. Dean Smith's team averaging about 13 for 19 from the line. They only got to the line five times in the first half.
45-44 Maryland. Simpkins for three. Got it. Second three-pointer for Dwayne. He's hitting 55% of his threes in ACC competition.
McGinnis trying to draw the foul, allowed Simpkins to get the room to shoot that shot. Man-to-man for Maryland.
Jameson turns, shoots, hits. 10 for Antoine. 48-46. And keep in mind, North Carolina has not lost back-to-back games in 3 years. Coming off that loss to State Saturday, Rhodes banks it. He'll go to the line.
Get fouled by Calabria, I believe.
And Dick Paparo heard something he didn't particularly like. Turned around to see from whence it came. Mr. Calabria's second foul.
Johnny Rhodes is an awfully tough guy to guard down inside because he has guard and perimeter skills, but he's probably just as effective down inside with his back to the basket. Tough matchup for Calabria or for anybody else.
Talk a lot about Johnny's steals. Only three men in ACC history with more steals than assists in their careers. Rhodes, Thomas Hill at Duke, and Dudley Bradley here at North Carolina. 49-46. Out of bounds to Maryland.
And there's Rhodes again. That Rhodes-Okolaja matchup. When Okolaja's got the ball and he sees Rhodes there, he just ought to get rid of it right away because Rhodes has been knocking it away from him with regularity tonight.
49-46 Terps. His reaction to the foul call by St. Croft and bangs him with a tee. And that will count as a personal against Jeff, his first of the game.
So you've got a personal foul on Okolaja.
That's the third on Okolaja.
Okolaja's body goes through Booth right there, knocks the ball away. The foul is called. That's Okolaja's reaction, but it was Jeff McGinnis' reaction that earned the technical foul. Bob, you pointed out just the previous possession when a foul was called. Somebody said something that Dick Paparo didn't like. We saw him turn around and look in the crowd.
Simpkins shooting. And why not? An 86% foul shooter to lead the conference.
The crowd of players, that is. This is a good crew. These guys will give you lot of room, but there's a line that you should better not go across, that you should not cross, and unfortunately for Dean Smith and the Tar Heels, it was crossed.
Here's Booth. 51-46 Maryland. And Simpkins gets the bounce.
Boy, that's a big basket.
Point play for the Terrapins. 53-46.
Terrapins. opens, threatening pressure.
And a steal. Oh, Simpkins couldn't handle it.
Simpkins did not expect the ball to be there, Bob. He was scrambling to get back in the corner to cover up Dante Calabria.
No possession. No possession. The clock stays the same.
The shot clock shows 23 seconds. Team possession was not lost for the Tar Heels. Okalaja up top, Zwicker. Tar Heels set it up.
Man-to-man defense for the Terps.
Calabria backs it out of traffic. Shot clock at 10. And here comes Maryland's pressure again coming.
Oh, he double dribbled the basketball.
Mario Lucas came up with the steal, but the turnover gives it right back to North Carolina.
And Bob, he's going to create the turnover, and then he's going to double dribble on a wasted dribble. There's no reason to dribble this ball. Throw it to Keith Booth or throw it to Dwayne Simpkins. That's just a wasted dribble, and he pays for it with a turnover. You should only be bouncing that ball when you're going somewhere with it.
Okalaja up and in. His first bucket of the game. Other end. Whoa, smothered. Great block. Okalaja got back the other end and blocked it. Williams for three. Rebound kicked by Calabria out to the hands of Johnny Rhodes. 2-on-1 Maryland. Rhodes to him. Back to Rhodes. Great break. Boy, what a terrific play, too, by Okalaja at both ends. The bucket, then the block. Great action. A 3-on-none for Simpkins.
And Dean Smith wants a 20-second timeout. The Maryland defense has taken over in the last couple of possessions, Bob.
And the 9-point lead on the board at 57-48. Time now for our smart play of the week. And we go to the North Carolina NC State game from Saturday night. Friends, take a look at this play. As the ball goes inside, every Tar Heel is looking at Todd Fuller. But Todd makes the smart play by finding the open man. And this distance, it's Danny Strong for the three-point shot. State hit 14 threes on Saturday.
Maryland's defense creating some fast break opportunities. Here's the last one. Rhodes to hip and back to Rhodes. Another scramble inside for the basketball. This is the same play from another angle. Johnny Rhodes gets it to X-ray hip, and they execute that fast break very well. Maryland with 14 points off 12 North Carolina turnovers. Calabria yet to be a factor offensively in this game.
Zwicker way short. Rebound to Booth. Calabria, averaging 13.6 a game, has scored four. Lucas for three. He can hit that one wide open and does.
Boy, you give him that long to load it up, Bob. He's going to make most of them.
Maryland by 12 at 60-48. Calabria for three. Zwicker and a foul on Maryland. And it's on to Lucas. His second.
Bob, we talked about the North Carolina turnovers, and that's been important to Maryland. Also has been Gary Williams' club ability to stop the offensive rebound. North Carolina getting one that time.
11:39 to go in Chapel Hill. It's Maryland by a dozen.
There's a fine line of motor oil separating your car's engine parts that's as little as a thousandth of an inch. But friction and heat can make motor oil become volatile and vaporize, weakening its ability to protect expensive parts. Texaco Havoline Formula 3 is formulated to control volatility, fight vaporization, and provide complete engine protection, no matter what you drive.
Add more life to your car. Take it to the stars. each new season, they rouse themselves from their dens. The ACC Superfan. Starved for ACC basketball and food, they're drawn to Food Lion. There they quench their thirst, satisfy their hunger, and get everything else they need. And when they use their MVP card, they can win tickets to the ACC and the National College Basketball Championship. If you see an ACC superfan, beware. They're usually not alone. Food Lion. Extra low prices and more for the ACC superfan.
The new Chrysler Sebring was built upon something called the Goldilocks principle.
It occurred to us that while most luxury cars were too big, most sport coupes were too small. We wanted the Sebring to be, well, just right.
It not only has a sporty 24-valve engine and a race-inspired suspension, but it also gives you the luxury of an actual back seat.
Which means there's enough room for Goldilocks and three or four of her friends.
Into the ACC archives we go. First, February the 20th, 1986, the Dean Smith Center was 5 games old when Maryland came to Chapel Hill. The Tar Heels had won all five, but this was Len Bias' night. The senior Terp scored 35 to hand Carolina their first loss at the Dean Dome. Then about 4 years later, the Terps got their second and last win at the Smith Center. Gerard Mustang had 27 points and 8 boards as Maryland swept the Tar Heels in 1990, winning this game 80-76. The Terrapins, one of 4 teams in the league with multiple wins here. Duke, Georgia Tech, and NC State, the others. But remember the comeback, and the king of comebacks, Dean Smith and the Tar Heels, they'll have to do it one more time, down 12 with 11:30 left. Jamison missing, Zwicker gets an offensive rebound and a stick back. Point, Dan.
And that's actually the third opportunity. Zwicker got an offensive rebound before we went away to the break. So North Carolina with 3 opportunities on that possession, and they convert it.
Lucas over Zwicker.
Lucas can be a very dangerous offensive player. Dean Smith realizing that Lucas is feeling it.
McGinnis.
Done a nice job showing different defensive looks all night, Bob, never letting North Carolina get comfortable against one defensive set.
Jamon Williams with hip flying at him, or rather Laurent Proffitt. Second three tonight for Jamon. And the Terps turn it over. McGinnis up and out. Out of bounds to Maryland. Away by Zwicker.
Booth really doing a great job inside for Maryland. Zwicker almost had another offensive rebound. And Proffitt and Stokes are in the game for Maryland, and they're about to come out as Hip and Simpkins report back to the scorer's table.
Here's Proffitt taking it to the rim and putting it in. How'd he get that one off? Great move. 64-53. McGinnis gets it into Zwicker. Back out to Jeff. The drive, the jump shot. The rebound to Jamon Williams.
And another offensive rebound. And Keith Booth is sitting inside on Antoine Jameson.
The sub's coming in. We'll take a little
Booth is just sitting there. He's sitting on top of Jameson. He's not getting off. That's a pretty good play if you can get away with it.
And it's going to belong to the Tar Heels. Well, the Terps on fire to start this second half.
You make 80% of your shots, usually you got a pretty good chance of winning the game.
Any place. Calabria barely drew iron. 3-on-2, Booth. X going right to the bucket and a charge. And an excellent call.
He just put his head down and bowled his way to the basket. Earlier in the game, we saw Johnny Rhodes pull up and take a little jump shot. The little jump shot's available right there, but you see Hip just lower his head and shoulder and plow right into Calabria.
And for Dante, the 25th charge that he's drawn this year. Okalaja. Back out, Williams has it. Carolina down 11, and we just moved under 9 to play. Swicker, nope. Okalaja got up there, but Lucas claims it.
Okalaja got up there, but he had Booth in front of him. Would have been a great rebound, but he wasn't able to secure it.
Keith is averaging 9.4 rebounds a game in ACC competition.
Tar Heels back to the man-to-man.
Shot clock hits 10. Here's Stokes. Not a Lucas. His shot. Good again.
He is loading up.
He hit 4 threes against Carolina in the College Park game.
He obviously feels very comfortable with his shot at the moment, Bob.
Okalaja penetrating. The leaner is good.
Bob, we talked about Calabria's struggles. Dante Calabria 0 for 6 from three-point range tonight.
And you get the feeling to win this game, Calabria and McGinnis. And Williams had to do it from the perimeter as well. Here's Hip. It's blocked, but back to Lucas.
Bob, he took too much time in there. If he turns and shoots the ball quickly, he's got an easy shot, but he took too much time to get ready.
Stokes out to Booth. .722 remaining. Here's McGinnis penetrating. That one slapped away and a foul on Stokes. Terrell's second. Akizi and Luke and Johnny Rhodes coming back in now for Maryland as Lucas and Stokes go out of the game. Vince Carter now coming in for Okalaja.
Okalaja and Swicker both out of the game, Bob, so North Carolina going with a smaller lineup.
McGinnis in that game also added 9 assists to those 16 points. He had hit 15 straight free throws before that miss. This is the first time in the second half, Dan, the Tar Heels have gone to the foul line.
As we said, Bob, they get there almost 20 times a game. They've only been there 7 in this game.
Timeout at the Smith Center. We'll be back after this message from Budweiser. His offensive struggles continue. Dante with only 4 and 2 of 8 from the floor.
More importantly, he's a 43% three-point shooter, and he's 0 for 6.
Carolina coming with some pressure, but only on the inbounds pass. Now they relax it as Simpkins brings it up. Deep boot. Spins to the bucket. High off the glass and a foul on Williams.
In this man-to-man defense without Zwicker in the ballgame, a guy like Keith Booth with the quickness to get by his man on the perimeter and the power to operate inside draws the foul, and Zwicker that quickly gets up off the bench and re-enters the game.
The thing that struck me through the years with Keith Booth, Dan, is at his spot, that four spot, he normally goes against guys a lot bigger with a lot more weight, and he more than holds his own.
He's not had a big game offensively tonight, but he's done a very good job on the defensive end of the court, particularly on the defensive boards.
Keith has been averaging 12 rebounds a game over the last 5 games, and what a week he had last week. As you see Okalaja coming back, Keith Booth had 26 points and 16 rebounds at Virginia, then followed that Saturday with a 15.8 rebound performance against Bobby Crumman's Yellow Jackets.
Bob, a lot of talk about these Maryland seniors never having won here at the Smith Center. They had never won at Virginia until their victory over the Cavaliers last week. And they're trying to make it a couple of firsts.
Jameson had it stripped. Johnny Rhodes. Who else? And now him going to the bucket. And the foul on McGinnis.
Maryland's defense continues to create opportunities for their offense. McGinnis elects to try to take the charge, but Hip at the last minute changes directions, and McGinnis reaches out and grabs him. That was a pretty good job by Hip at full speed to change directions, because McGinnis was setting up to try to draw the charge.
X-Ray Hip and Serge Zwicker coming out of Hocker Prep. Stu Vetter was there at that time. You see the latest steal numbers on Johnny Rhodes. Number two behind Chris Corciani, all time in the ACC. 20 back now after tonight's performance, and he may get a few more yet.
There's still 6.5 minutes left in the game, Bob. I don't think he's done yet.
13-point Maryland lead. A very pensive crowd here at the Smith Center.
And there he is again.
A two-on-two. Rhodes from the foul line. And this Maryland club is playing like the one that was picked to win it. 71-56, Terrapin, Zwicker, and Johnny Rhodes with a pick, 3-on-1 break, Simpkins going in, count it.
They ought to just throw the ball to the other side. That's Dean Smith telling him, get it on the other side of the court, don't bring it over here by Rhodes.
Timeout, North Carolina.
More comfortable shooting the threes, I think, than layups.
Williams for three.
Calls a 20-second timeout, even though his team is still up 12. He feels the crowd coming into it, and you can just sometimes feel North Carolina getting set to get on a run, and I think Gary Williams feels that right now.
Shamon Williams had a great open look here. So Lucas trying to come, but he was way too late. And Shamon Williams, who hit some big threes in the Duke comeback win, nails his third tonight. Double figures for the Greenville, South Carolina sophomore, now with 11.
Bob, you cannot stop that penetration by people like McGinnis and Calabria without giving up something. And Dean Smith now has Williams in the ballgame along with McGinnis and Calabria. So with the way Maryland has played defense tonight, Williams may get some more open looks at the basket. And Dean Smith and his staff have to hope that the ball will go down just as it did the last time. Here's the zone.
Booth, Hip, Simpkins, they work the perimeter. Skip to Rhodes, quick inside the Booth. Nice hang and bang.
Bob, again, he's very effective in there. Without Zwicker in the game, Booth can play inside against Jamison and Okalaja. Doesn't have any difficulty getting his shot off.
Jamison with the catch. Lucas with the foul.
That was a big-time catch, Bob. That ball was looked like it was headed out the door. Okalaja with the pass, and Jamison really has to stretch out to get it. One-handed catch, then draws the foul.
Antoine.
He's only scored 2 points in the second half.
And the big second half. At NC State Saturday, Terrapin fans will have that shot of Antoine Jamison at College Park etched in their minds for a long time.
So will the Maryland fans.
.432 remaining.
Gary Williams gets much further out of that coach's box. He'll be down next to Dean.
Shamon Williams to trigger.
Nobody ever accused Gary of being lackadaisical, though.
And a whistle.
Vic Paparo just telling Johnny Rhodes to take a step or two back.
We know you're good, but you can't pick his pocket while he's out of bounds.
Man-to-man defense.
Calabria. Six.
X-ray Hip working as hard as a guy can work on defense, but Calabria taking it all the way to the bucket.
4:07 remaining. overtime with Calabria on the seat of his pants and Jamison just beating the horn by an instant. And Carolina won that game. Well, the Tar Heels were down in those first three. The Wake comeback, the Duke comeback were here at home. The State game was on the road. Can they do it one more time? I'll say this to Dean Smith. It's a tough way to make a living.
Bob, that's really a good news, bad news kind of thing. The good news is you've been able to come back, but the bad news is you get yourself down that far all the time.
Terrell Stokes, the Philadelphia freshman, entrusted right now at the point for Gary Williams. Lucas missing that three. Tipped, and Okalaja claims it.
I think Lucas is going to come out of the game pretty quickly.
Jamison, he's hammered, but they did deny the layup, but Antoine hits the deck hard. And Lucas, the first to check on it. Fourth on Mario. Boy, Antoine has taken a couple of tough shots in the last few days. He's one of his own teammates.
Now, Gary Williams and the Terrapins had better be careful, because as Jamison gets fouled here, keep in mind that before he banged heads with Serge Zwicker on Saturday night, he had 2 points and one rebound. After he banged his head, he had 16 points and seven rebounds. So Mario Lucas may have done a very bad thing in mocking Jamison to the deck.
And Jamison will come out of the game. And Zwicker will be shooting the free throws. Two shots. Serge, a 61.3% foul shooter. That's his 15th point tonight. His season high, 18. One for two. Tip to Kesey, saves it. And Calabria right in his shirt. Now Booth has got it. Another double team and a foul on Calabria.
That's great hustle by Calabria. Picked up the foul, his third foul. They had the Terps in trouble in the corner.
3:24 left. 17 fouls as Carter returns for Zwicker. So Maryland moves to the bonus.
Williams' squad, and now becomes very important for the Terrapins to convert these opportunities from the free throw line. They've created some opportunities with their defense, and they've been able to convert it. Now they need to convert their opportunities from the line.
Keith is 2 for 2 at the line tonight, hitting 78-7 in league play. Coming in now is Rodney Elliott for the Maryland Terrapins, and Akeezy goes out. As Keith Booth bids for double figures for the 13th consecutive game. ...77-68. Stokes with the knock away. It's out of bounds to the Tar Heels with 20 seconds on the shot clock.
Stokes really did a great job moving his feet and cutting Williams off. Coach Gary Williams, with Rhodes and Stokes and Simpkins all in the game at the same time, that's a pretty quick lineup.
Here's Jamison returning. Controlling McGinnis. Jamison just now getting to his feet. Timeout. And Dick Paparo stops the clock here to check on Jamison. The wet spot where Antoine went down.
Jamison is discovering that certain times it's safer over on the bench. He was down. He sat down on the bench because he got knocked down under the basket. That time he got knocked down out in front of the scorer's table. Vince Carter coming back in, but it's Okalaja going out.
16 on the shot clock.
Stokes got it again.
From behind that time. Now Booth and a knee by Williams.
Really some confidence by Gary Williams to insert a freshman, Terrell Stokes, into the game at a time like this with North Carolina making a comeback, showing some great confidence in the young man, and he has rewarded him. Stokes doing a tremendous job, two consecutive defensive possessions.
And you look at the stats too, Dan, on the offensive end, Stokes has committed only 8 turnovers in 8 ACC games. What a number for a freshman.
He just showed you something on those two plays guarding Williams.
Booth with 11 and a perfect 5 of 5 at the line. Two-time honorable mention All-ACC. 6th in the conference in foul shooting. 5th in rebounding, 12th in scoring. Having a marvelous year.
Just a warrior's heart in that game.
Mm-hmm.
Misses that free throw hard.
Tar Heel Warriors trying to mount another comeback. 78-68. McGinnis for 3. Got it.
Calabria, who struggled all game on the offensive end, set a big screen that time to allow McGinnis to have a little room.
Stokes to Simpkins. Back across to Booth. Maryland spreading the floor.
Now they've got to stay aggressive. They want to run some time off the clock, but they want to attack the basket and get a good opportunity as the clock runs down. North Carolina in the man-to-man.
Now you see Gary Williams shouting out, run the offense, and that means Simpkins a shot. And a foul on Elliott on the back. Free throws for Vince Carter coming up. To play, the Maryland lead at 7.
Bob, I think in that situation, Simpkins had the open look at the 3. However, Keith Booth was down on the block, and he had Shamon Williams on him. I think that what you have to be able to do as the clock runs down is recognize mismatches when they occur, and I think the smart play that time would have been to go inside to Keith Booth. Of course, it's a whole lot easier to see that over here.
78-71 over the Tar Heels with Vince Carter going to the line. Friends, we have a doubleheader for you this Saturday at 1:30. Maryland takes on Florida State. Keith Booth looking to continue his great play over the last month against the Seminoles. And then at 4 p.m., Clemson travels to Virginia. Harold Dean and the Cavaliers looking for a payback after the loss at Clemson when Harold scored 39. Then Sunday at 1:30, a Big Four matchup with Duke and Winston-Salem. The use of this broadcast without their express permission is prohibited. Long way to go in this one. 2-0-1 and a 7-point.
Free throws. It's a 1-1 opportunity for Vince Carter.
It in. It's his 8th point of the game.
If he's able to convert this free throw, look for North Carolina to come with some pressure. For Maryland, the Terrapins holding the lead. They'd like to run some time off the clock, but they don't have the opportunity to just hang on to the ball, Bob. There's still plenty of time left to go in the game, so they're going to have to get something offensively. Now, with this substitution, Okalaja back in the game. It enables Dean Smith to stop the action, get his defense set.
Stokes up the sideline and throws it away. There, the freshman buckled to the pressure.
Well, it's a tough spot for the young man. The ball just slips off his hand. You ducked pretty quickly there, Bob. I was impressed. You're faster than that guy in the yellow sweater.
Under 2 to play. Here's Calabria. And loose in the lane, double dribble. A double dribble on Calabria. Gives it back to Maryland. That time he had hip on him and was able to go in the lane.
Bob Stokes is coming back in the ball game right now. Calabria loses the ball, dribbles it, loses it again. but the double dribble was called before that last series of action. And here Stokes is right back in the ballgame.
17 Tar Heel turnovers. Maryland could stand another conversion here. Up by five. Rhodes can't handle it. The pass too tall, and a minute 38 to go. Carolina basketball.
And Gary Williams doing a little offense, defense substitution. He's got Hip back in the game. Look for Hip to be matched up once again with Calabria.
Shimon. 17 for Shimon Williams, a career high. Carolina has scored 8 unanswered to cut it to 2. Saves it. Shot clock at 15.
Tremendous defensive pressure, but plenty of time for Maryland to get a good shot.
Inside the booth. Got it back. And puts it up and off. Tipped by Rhodes. No. Jamison out of bounds. No. Carolina ball. 49.2 seconds to play. Carolina can tie with a 2, take the lead with a 3.
The biggest job Dwayne Simpkins has right now is to keep Jeff McGinnis in front of him. Don't let McGinnis penetrate to the basket.
He does penetrate. Loose. Foul on Maryland. And with 33-6 remaining, the Tar Heels have a chance to tie.
McGinnis gets to the basket, misses the first shot. In fact, Booth blocked it. But look who's there for that rebound. Jamison has a way of being around the basketball. Got a couple of big free throws now.
Two shots for Antoine. He's 3 of 6 at the line. They're within 1 point of doing it again. Down 17 at 73-56. If Jamison is successful, this game will be tied. But first, Maryland takes a timeout.
They can't.
This game was tied was way back at 23-all. McGinnis on Simpkins.
North Carolina is just not going to let him hold the ball. They're going to foul Stokes, who is a less than 60% free throw shooter.
He will have the benefit of 2 free throws, as that's the 10th Carolina team foul.
But he's only a 57% free throw shooter on the year. That almost looked like Shimon Williams was trying to do that.
And Terrell Stokes finding out what ACC pressure is all about. That silences the 21,000 plus. From Simon Gratz in Philadelphia. Second free throw for Stokes. Got it. Maryland by 2 with 20.4 remaining.
And they get Hip and Elliott back in the game for defensive purposes.
80-78 Maryland. Here come the Heels. 2 to tie, 3 to win. Williams kicks it out of bounds.
Johnny Rhodes knocked it away again.
Johnny Rhodes with incredible defense tonight. And now Maryland's got the ball.
Johnny Rhodes just flicks that left hand in there, hits the ball, and then Shimon Williams kicks it out of bounds. Dean Smith, you see in the background, not happy at all with that particular turn of events.
Into Stokes, they foul him again. 11.1 left, and Stokes back to the line. A look at our MVPs for the game. Jamon Williams for North Carolina had 17 points and hit 5 threes tonight. He's our North Carolina MVP. Food Line will make a $1,000 donation on their behalf to the ACC Operation Outreach Fund, which benefits deserving middle schools throughout the ACC region. Stokes hits it again.
Now, Bob, Maryland is not out of the woods here yet. It's still a one-possession game.
Carter back.
This is a very big free throw.
Terrell hit two at 20.4, and now trying to hit two more at 11-1 to put the Terps up four. And the freshman trying to nail it down for the seniors at Chapel Hill. Missed it, but Booth, the offensive rebound, he is fouled. It's on McGinnis. So the miss, Dan Bonner, but it's Booth, 22.
And now what a great job by Booth. He was blocked out, but he held his position, didn't jump over the back of Okalaja, waited for the rebound to come to him. That's just a tremendous play that you would expect from a guy with the experience possessed by Keith Booth. What a ball game he's played.
9.3 left. Misses the first one.
And they still have to make this second one.
Right.
To create the two-possession game.
Got it. Now the Tar Heels. Down by four. Calabria zips it to midcourt. Okalaja has it. Gives to Carter. His three-pointer is no good. Rebound Simpkins and a foul on Calabria. And with 2.6 left, that should just about do it with Maryland up by four.
Bob, Dean Smith has seen his team twice in a row now fall way behind and come all the way back but not be able to pull it out. Tremendous effort by the Maryland Terrapins. Plenty of heroes to go around. This guy at the free throw line was one of them. An excellent defensive effort tonight against Jeff McGinnis, Johnny Rhodes with 174 steals.
Tonight.
Keith Booth with an outstanding effort. X-ray hip with 11 points in the second half.
So the Maryland seniors, who had gone 0 for 3 here and lost by an average of 15 points a game, head back to College Park with an 84-78 win. Gary Williams shakes the hand of Dean Smith as Maryland continues its roll. The Terps have won six out of their last seven, and they are now 5-4 in the ACC. What a ball game. Carolina drops to 7-3, and Wake Forest takes over first in the conference. Johnny Rhodes ends up with 9 steals tonight, matching his Maryland record that he established earlier against American University. What a night for the senior from Washington, D.C. A whale of a game for the Maryland Terrapins. They win it 84-78. For Dan Bonner and our entire ACC crew, this is Bob Rathbun thanking you for joining us. You have been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on the Raycom and Jefferson Pilot Sports Network. Again, our final score tonight at Chapel Hill, the Terrapins 84 and the Tar Heels 78. So long, everybody, from Chapel Hill.